Ottawa selects from Dergard and Mika Zibanejad.
Tim Murray, the assistant GM, makes the call on Mika Zibanejad, who was one of the two wild cards, really, in his early first round, the other being Ryan Murphy of the Kitchener Rangers. Zibanejad with the most intriguing background, maybe of any player in the draft.
Let's keep all this straight here. His dad's name is Mirhad. He's an Iranian. His mom's name is Ritsa. She's Finnish. Mika speaks Farsi, Finnish, Swedish, and English. He's a big, strong, physical center who's also got some real good offensive ability. He has 1 year left on his contract at Djurgården, but the NHL agreement does allow for him to try out for the NHL team if signed before July 15th. And if he doesn't make it, get returned to Sweden to finish out his contract.
Djurgården's the same team that produced a big center not too many moons ago when the draft was back in Minnesota. Matt Sundin in 1989, first overall in that draft. And this is Mika Zibanejad. The biggest thing about him, everybody says, he looks like a nice guy. He plays like a nice guy. If you get in a one-on-one confrontation with him, he's not so nice. This is a player that's not far from being NHL ready. I think you're right, though, Bob. He'll stay another year in Djurgården. But for Ottawa Senators and their offense that was so starved, 192 goals last year, the worst in the National Hockey League, you now have second-line insulation for Jason Spezza down the middle.
So far we've had six picks in the draft. Three are Canadian and three are Swedish. And again, Sweden making its name early on, as it has in recent years of the NHL draft.
Bob talked about David Rundberg playing in Skellefteå. Now he's part of the Ottawa Senators organization. Ottawa's very comfortable taking Swedes. Daniel Alfredsson is their captain. And now you look at what's going on with them. Erik Karlsson's part of their team. They are not afraid of Swedish players, much like New Jersey. It's going to work out for this kid. I couldn't be happier for the fans in Ottawa. He is a quick strike offensive player.
Now, when you look at the offensive totals, Bob, you see the eight goals. Remember that in the men's league, in Sweden, young players quite often don't play. So for a 17 or 18-year-old player to get regular ice time in the Swedish Elite League, which you could argue is the second best league in the world, is something.
He had 4 goals and 8 points in 6 games at the World Under 18 in April when he's playing against his peers, his own age group. You're right, Gord. He's big, he's strong. He's still getting to fill out a little bit more, but he also has the ability to score goals and be physical. He does both those things equally well. I alluded to the fact the NHL has a transfer agreement with Sweden. Understand how this works. If he is signed before July 15th, he can try out for the Ottawa Senators. And if he makes the team, they can bypass his last year in his contract on Djurgården. If he doesn't make the team, then they are obliged to send him back to play in the Swedish Elite League for another year.